Is that for recording, is it? Right, so what I'm going to show you is the 12 volt system. Right, now what it's showing now is a failure. So we've got this is flashing, and you should have a red light inside your button.
Yep.
Okay, so that's a failure. It's failing on the 12 volt system at the moment because it's not connected to the car, and the car is not running. So the car engine has to be running to supply the 12 volt system to this fridge. If it's doing that on the gas, that means the gas hasn't lit. So the things obviously to check is you've got gas, you've turned your gas on.
Yeah.
Okay. The other thing, if light your cooker up, make sure you've got gas running. Or down here is there's individual appliance gas taps as well, which may have been left switched off, you know, but you don't need to touch them anyway. So the other reason why it may be not lighting on the gas is it's got air in the system. If you tend to run it on electric all the time, as I said, fire it up every now and again, it may have air in the system.
Yep.
So the only way to get rid of that is by switching the whole fridge off, give it a few seconds, then switch it back on again. It'll reattempt to light it. Okay?
Yep.
So what it's doing is purging the air out the system to get to the gas. Okay?
Okay.
So just press the grey button until just the one icon is flashing. So if I want to try it on gas or electric, confirm it, temperature-wise as well. It should both light up, say that's what you've set.
Yep.
You should have a green light inside your button, and they will go out and off to sleep. It will also remember, you switch it off now, I've got it on electric, if I switch it off now, and then you come back, you go up on site. Got a 12 volt igniter there on that switch. So obviously all you do is just turn and press the switch and away it goes. Obviously don't put the glass down while you've got heat on it. That can shatter. Obviously, so make sure it is cooled down before you put that down. Grill, same again, off your 12 volt igniter there. Make sure it's up and running.
Yep.
Okay.
Ooh.
Right, I'm going to say the handle. Can't see the grill pan handle in there. I'll find that for you.
The oven.
And the oven as well.
Yep.
Okay, exactly the same. Obviously make sure you keep the grill door open when you're obviously using that. Okay?
Yep.
Microwave, big button opens it. Don't travel with glass plate in, because if that drops down and drops onto here, that's going to shatter and it's going to be expensive. Right, they're really expensive to replace. So just sneak that under there for now. My wife tends to put it in the bowl there with a tea towel or something like that, wrapped around it, stopping it rattling about. Okay, if you see that control there, that does nothing, unless you press one of the buttons. Okay, microwave button, press that once. That is now your energy, so 100%, 10% or whatever your setting is, obviously normally 100. Press the microwave button again, and then turn the control again, and that gives you your seconds. Okay, don't ask me why it's so complicated. But obviously then press start and away it goes. Right?
Yeah.
Happy with that. There's also a quick start as well on the start button, which goes up in minute increments and starts straight away.
Alright, okay, brilliant.
Okay, yeah, so that doesn't do anything on its own. You have to press the microwave button twice to get the seconds. Start, go. Right? Don't ask me why it's so complicated, I do not know. Right. Radio, which hopefully I think was in this one.
Radio?
Radio CD player. I'm getting excited then. So yeah, I've got an MP3 player if you want to plug in there. Source button, which switches it on, goes through auxiliary AM, FM. How loud the engineers have turned it up. Obviously volume button, press the centre to mute it. Also you've got the searches left and right there. Okay, and obviously presets. Single CD player. Also eject button there, ejects the front off the radio there if you want to. Okay, and that little one there just switches it on and off. Sam?
Yeah?
Just go and find the grill pan and clips to the side of your sink. Then individual gas appliance taps which are down there on the left hand wall.
Yep.
You've got an info note there to tell you what they're connected to.
Yeah.
Okay. So as I said before, you don't need to turn them on or off. Okay, to operate it, undo the nut. Then you can push.
I've got a video.
Yeah, so you can push that up and use it. It has got an indicator there on this label here. It says denotes the rear of the antenna. So you have a look to see where everybody else is pointing theirs. So then you can just direct that to wherever position you want it to. And obviously, once it's up, lock it off. If, have a look, see if anybody's turned theirs up that way around, because you can change it from horizontal to vertical by using this little contraption underneath.
Right,
see that there, it goes into red, vertical.
Yeah.
Obviously you don't want to travel it with it like that, so make sure it's in the green before you bring it back down again. And obviously bring the whole thing down as well.
Yeah.
So it's less likely of collecting any trees on the way home. So got an electric 12 volt flush system. As I said before, if there's nothing coming out, obviously it's empty. You hear that? It's empty. The toilet does swivel, so don't think it's falling off when you're sitting on it. You've got a wastegate, which I was talking about before, which is this lever down here. You can see that one there. So just obviously open it to use it, flush it, and then once you use it, shut it back again.
Yeah.
Okay. Obviously that keeps the nice smells out. Okay. Obviously make sure it's in that position shut for when you take the waste cassette out. Okay?
It's not very mean. Mario Kart game, won't it, on there?
And you can go and empty it as well.
Yeah.
Right. Light switches on the end of the basin here, cleverly hidden. And obviously your taps and your shower, they're all the same, they're all mixer taps. So if you are going to use a shower on board,